Hey, Pete, you ready to come by the foundation?
Sure. I'm excited to see what you're up to.
Great. I'm excited to show you.
Oh, gotta grab this call from MJ. See you soon.
Hey, how you doing?
Good. Just got off the phone with Harry, and this foundation thing could be interesting.
Oh, nice. Some hope on my work front, too. I dug into the tech that gang used to mess with the prison transfer. It's DARPA-level stuff.
Yeah. Whoever's behind them has a ton of resources. Miles thinks he saw their leader, some kind of big game hunter, fur vest-looking guy.
Interesting. I'll keep digging. If I can get this story on the front page, it might help us track him down faster. Maybe save my job, too.
My suit's heat shielding still works well. Everything okay?
We're about to demolish a hospital that was damaged during Sandman's attack, but there's a lot of debris slowing down the technicians. If you're free, they could really use your webs to help keep the building stable while they work.
Absolutely.
Thanks. We'll keep working until you get here.
I was wondering what this place was. That's Emily's tree.
You made it!
I thought you said this was a startup.
Yeah, I was hoping for something a little less this. But my dad was the one who, you know, he made all the arrangements.
Peter Parker! So, what do you think? It's a far cry from that chop shop that Otto had you in. And now that you're on board, this place is really gonna start cooking.
Dad, Pete hasn't decided he's joining yet.
Oh. Really?
But I was gonna give him a tour. Let him decide for himself.
All right. You know, seeing you boys together again. Right then. Have fun.
Get your badge out. Let's go exploring. So the first thing I want to show you is downstairs.
Harry, this place...
Right? Dad went a little more over the top than I would have liked.
How did you...
I got things set up while I was still undergoing treatment, but when I got out, I made a few changes.
Like what?
Diverted my salary into research projects, installed a diverse board to keep us on the right track, and made sure all research aligned with our mission. To heal the world. First, I want you to meet Dr. Young, who's a leading entomologist. You know what entomology is?
Yeah.
Dr. Young is doing this super cool research on bees. Or, to be more precise, on bee predators.
Cross-tabulate with the AI learning we did during the last milestone.
Ready to talk to Dr. Young?
You must be Peter. So nice to meet you. I think you'll like this project.
Great to meet you, Dr. Young. Harry says you're working with bees.
Yes, and it's quite an urgent situation. A full third of the food you eat every day comes from crops pollinated by bees. But worldwide populations are in steep decline. Primarily due to a significant predator, the carnivorous bee wolf. So, we developed an innovative way to help the bees. Wanna see how?
Whoa, this is cool!
These little drones are essentially bee bodyguards that we're training to detect and attack bee wolves.
AKA, bee killer wasps.
And you're helping with the machine learning algorithm. Do you see those little holographic bee wolves? The better you are at shooting those, the better our drones get at recognizing what to target.
The idea is for the drones to scare the bee wolves, not hurt them.
Oh, nice! Yes! Yep!
Hear that, little bee wolves? You still get to pollinate another day, too.
Yeah! Gotta protect the hive! Nice! You're not gonna mess with my bees! Gotcha!
Wow! You're done, Peter. A very productive session. We got great data.
Okay, flying home.
Welcome to entomology.
If those virtual bee wolves you just took out were real, you'd have saved the lives of about 2,500 bees.
Wow. I'd love to help any way I can. I could take a look at juicing the neural networks, Pete.
Oh, yes, please.
Maybe if Pete decides to join us, you two can talk some more. Thanks, Dr. Young. I've got so much more to show you, Pete. Let's go. Now, up ahead is the medical research area. We're doing cutting-edge proton beam work, using protons instead of X-rays, with better targeting and less radiation.
It's all the stuff we talked about. All the stuff we dreamed could make the world a better place.
That's the idea.
Harry, a moment, if you please.
Any chance it can wait a sec?
It'll be quick. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Doc, this is my friend Peter. Peter, Dr. Connors.
We've actually met. I used to work with Dr. Octavius. You came to the lab once to consult on electrotactile stimuli.
Oh. Yes. It's a shame about Dr. Octavius. His work had so much promise.
Any changes since this morning?
Dizziness, aches, pains, anxiety, impulsive thoughts.
Nope. I've never been better.
That's what worries me. Nice to see you again.
Your doctor is the Lizard?
Dad believes in second chances. Hey, listen, I gotta go make a call, but feel free to explore. Come meet me upstairs when you're ready.
So that was crazy. But it seems to be working for everyone to have Dr. Connors here. Guess I'll look around.
The origins of life on Earth remain a mystery. How could organic life forms have arisen from non-biological chemical compounds? Recent discoveries of meteorites containing organic molecules considered the building blocks of life may provide a potent clue.
Cool. Wow. Guess this is what it's like working for an Osborne.
This is the original prototype from Otto's lab. This would have been crime scene evidence. Wonder how it ended up here. Let's see what's going on here. Maybe I can help. Oh, yeah, that would take a while. I'm not sure there's time to dig in now, but I'd sure like to come back and work on this later. So many cool things here!
Attention. Please use caution near the particle accelerator today. We are performing maintenance, and there may be stray cables.
Looks like Connors is putting the research he did after he lost his arm to good use. Wonder if he regrets testing that serum on himself. It must be unnerving walking around with dormant lizard DNA in your body.
Welcome to Space Research.
Sorry. There's so much to see here. Where do I even start? Yeah.
Hey, whenever you're ready, come meet me up here.
I'm on my way. I'll see you in a sec.
Did you hear about Roger?
Is he sick?
You really have a particle accelerator?
We use it to send proton beams to that treatment room downstairs. It's being repaired right now, but we'll have it back up in no time.
Incredible. Where are we heading now?
Up to the top floor.
Your energy seems really good, Harry.
I feel great. So put your way back helmet on and think back. Even before high school. To middle school.
Okay.
Please.
Now, do you know the...
Hang on.
Meditation class will be...
You're a popular guy.
Sorry, it's just my tutoring job. You were saying?
My dad's... You know the stuff everyone studies in middle school with Gregor Mendel and the pea plants?
Yeah, I think so. About genetics and plant hybridization?
Exactly. So, Dr. Foster up ahead, he's won every top prize in the field for his work with plant genetics.
Wow.
Hey, when you were walking around, did you have a chance to feed the fish?
No, I didn't.
Oh, you have to. It's seriously one of my favorite spots in the whole building. So calming, and we're doing cool research inspired by the cellular structure of the koi fish's scales.
I'll be sure to go check that out.
And in the degree of the root to be extracted?
Mm-hmm. I see what you're saying.
The algorithm is similar to long division, if you look at it that way.
Got it. Mm-hmm.
Dr. Foster.
Thanks, Dr. Foster.
Ah, Peter, I presume. Harry talks about you frequently.
So nice to meet you.
Dr. Foster is working on agricultural efficiency.
With the population growing and the climate changing unpredictably, we need to adapt more quickly than nature normally would. Genetic recombination can customize crops to best meet these new challenges, be it extreme weather or an increase in pests. Would you like to see this testbed?
Okay.
The idea is to tweak a plant's beautiful work, Peter. Using this technology, we're on track to end world hunger by 2035.
Wow. I know a rooftop you could use for a real-world test if you're interested.
Oh, very much so. Harry was right. You'll be a real asset here.
Thank you, Dr. Foster.
So now where?
Last stop. It might be my favorite. It's commanding, but not overbearing. Playful, but not tasteless. Impressive, but not show-offy.
Your office.
Or is it our office?
Harry.
Now remember, the things you've seen today are just a small taste of what we're working on. But don't decide just yet, not till you've seen this last thing.
Okay.
Come on, where's your badge? You'll need it to get in.
I really think we need more security.
Wow. Man. Harry. This is all so amazing. It's perfect, really. It's just... things are really hectic right now.
When I was in treatment, all I could think about was, what would I do if I survived? And I kept hearing my mom's voice, telling me that our planet is in trouble. And it's my responsibility to save it. If you join me, there's so much more that we can do. I mean, we both know you're the smarter one. Come on. Let's make my mom and May proud, huh?
It's amazing. But there's one thing. Can I move my desk over there? I like to face the wall when I work.
Oh, one quick thing.
I'm gonna need a little time to transition out of my tutoring job.
Of course. Take whatever time you need. It's all about balance, right?
But Coney Island later, yeah?
You bet.
Oh, hey, I forgot to tell you. Some of our researchers have field experiments set up around the city. If you have time, check them out. I've sent you the location, then your badge will grant you access.
All right, I'll swing by.